Matt Anderson is in the production, and Kira Huning and Matt Hurt have been helping us with makeup for this show. And I personally think it's hilarious that Matt's last name is Hurt, and he's making everybody all bloody and look like zombies and things like that. Can everybody remember to please turn their phones to silent or so there's no texting during the show? I'd like to thank Legacy Estates, Pediatric Dentistry, Union Bank and Trust, Energy Pro Lighting, Saloon Media, Dell, and Sid Dillon. They do a lot of really great things around here to help us out. There will be one intermission where we will have cookies and coffee and pop and all those wonderful things. And with that, I think that's it. Thank you very much.
Table solid, and there's a back door too.
Okay. Come on, Gary, you can give me a hand.
My
about your idea of something that was clever when I first heard it. Now I'm not so sure.
Stop worrying. What could go wrong?
Well, this old farmhouse has a dark reputation. Murders were committed here. Everyone says so.
Ancient history.
Remember last year? Old Mrs. Carlson said she saw something unearthly walking in the cemetery. She said it glowed in the dark, but she swears it's true.
Miss Carlson is senile.
She said it was something from the grave. She said it tried to bite her.
Good for you, Louise. You're getting into the mood. Zombie night is going to be a triumph.
I was being serious, Howie.
Let's check upstairs. If we're in luck, we'll find a creaking door. I figured we could put a skeleton in the landing and a vampire in one of the closets. If there's time, I want to dig a grave in the cellar.
I don't like the sound of that.
Listen to the children of the night. What music they make.
Howie, wait for me.
Here they are.
join us?
I thought Mike was one of the students getting here early.
Either that or a drifter.
Drifter?
You know, a hobo or a bum?
Oh, wouldn't that be nice? And I'd invite a guest. Maybe some sort of homicidal maniac.
I like it. When the others get here, we'll tell them there's a maniac loose. We'll tell them you heard it on the car radio. Last scene, head for the old cemetery.
Hey, maybe we could wear a Freddy Krueger mask.
Nah, Jason, hockey mask and chainsaw.
Love it!
No, too obvious. Freddy Krueger and Jason, they're dated. Like Vivian's miserable sock hop. Let me think.
What if he was a motorcycle gang leader who went insane after he inhaled too many exhaust fumes?
Nah.
He could be a woman.
Nah.
He could be a high school principal who went berserk. He could hate students.
I like that better than the rest, but it's still not right. Old farmhouse. Old cemetery.
Why not a crazy old farmer?
That's it. Yeah.
He roams the countryside looking for victims.
He plants the trumpet
in an old cemetery.
Just like an old movie on TV.
I can see him now. Bib overalls.
Long beard. Batted hat.
Dirty fingernails.
What are you doing in this house? Answer me. I've got a right to know. What are you doing in this house?
It's him. The homicidal maniac.
Relax, guys. I'm sure he's just flesh and blood. I think.
I hope.
Hello there, sir.
Got no right to be here. No right at all.
Were you standing outside the window a moment ago?
Yup.
Then it was you I saw?
Yup.
That's relief.
Is it?
Was it you that stole the boxes?
Don't know nothing about no box.
Oh, we're from the high school. My name is Howie Wilkins, and these are my friends. Gary.
Hi.
Louise. Phoebe.
Hi.
We're here to set up for a zombie night. Mr.
Lum. Everyone calls me Lum.
Lum. Okay. So, we're just getting the place ready.
Why?
Zombie night.
I don't get it!
Just say Lum. We then create one room, like a crazy maze, and another like a torture chamber. We pretend this is a haunted house full of terror. We dress up like zombies too.
That's just plain stupid.
The fun starts at midnight, Lum. You're invited.
Bring friends.
If you have one.
Why'd you pick this house?
Because it has a
reputation.
I thought as much. Bunch of tourists. That's all you are. This old farmhouse ain't public property. It belongs to me. I only rented it out to Dr. Thanatos.
Thanatos? Was he the doctor who did all those crazy experiments?
Yes.
Story?
Of course I do. I know more about what went on in this farmhouse more than anyone dare alive.
He murdered people, didn't he?
He tried to bring the dead back to life. That's not the same thing as murder. Maybe it is, because he had to kill them first.
Is looking at a real story?
Yes. It was like flies trapped in a spider's web. Dr. Thanatos was a spider. There was always folks losing their way in the dark, wondering where they were.
Oh boy, murder victims are us. We deliver.
Go on, Lum. This is getting interesting.
Yes. Whenever there's a storm, they move about. I think he has something to do with toxic rain.
Moves about.
Corpses.
I'm not resting easy then. What are they after?
I've said enough. You've been warned.
Oh. damage to the homestead, Uncle Mom. Honest.
We'll clean up after the party's over.
You mean you're gonna stay? After all I said? Stupid teenagers! There's a storm brewing up. That might not be...
me?
Healthy. Folks do disappear in these parts from time to time. Ain't saying this guy anything to do with this farmhouse.
Cellar. We can
He's on his way in.
Thank you.
You girls can't stay here. You gotta get out.
Get out?
I just got here.
We want to use the telephone.
Ha, no telephones. Come on.
There's no need to be rude. Stop shoving.
What's the matter with you?
No, 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 no. We'll get out now.
No, no, no. Gary! What are you doing?
They're leaving?
Nonsense. I'm Nurse Pim, Dr. Panatos' assistant.
Hi.
We've been hiking, but we lost our way. Luckily, we saw the light here in the house.
I understand. People are always losing their way in these parts. It gets dark so early this time of year. Dr. Thanatos will want to meet you.
No.
Gary, what's the matter with you? You've been acting strange all evening.
I feel dizzy.
I'm sure our guests would like a cup of something hot.
I wouldn't say no.
That would be nice. Thank you, Dr.
Coffee, hot Dutch chocolate, herbal tea.
Whatever.
Anything at all. We're not fussy.
Well, don't stand there like a great muff. Go into the kitchen and prepare the coffee, the hot Dutch chocolate, and the herbal tea.
Ugh, I wish I'd wake up.
Does Gary work here?
Part-time. He's from the local high school. I'm afraid he's not too bright. Dr. Thanatos, we have victims. Silly of me. I meant to say visitors. Visitors, Dr. Thanatos, we have visitors.
Everything is ready upstairs.
Splendid, Doctor. I'll prepare the injections.
You girls look healthy. The usual childhood diseases, I suppose. Mumps, tonsils.
Nonsense! You haven't even had your beverage.
We don't care for any. Thank you.
Sit down!
Yes, sir.
You girls don't realize that you soon will be famous!
Famous? We'd rather not be famous if you don't mind, Dr. Thanatos.
I am the world's greatest reanimator!
You mean you draw cartoons?
I mean I bring the dead back to life. Me, both of us, Thanatos!
Bravo, Doctor, bravo.
Ow! You won't feel a thing. Dead one moment, live the next.
It's a new process.
Ow!
Upsy daisies, girls. Up.
What's up, Doc?
Don't be impatient, my dears. All in good time.
Yes, Doctor.
I hope you'll be able to reanimate them. There have been so many mistakes lately.
That's what the old cemetery's for. See the hair-raising mysteries of Dr. Thanatos' laboratory.
I don't know how to make herbal tea.
That's trouble with schools these days. They don't teach you anything.
Something you ate.
Herbal tea.
Why do you keep saying that?
Hey, Gary, I need some help.